Southwest Utah is well known for its dazzling scenery, thanks to the world-class geology that is in plain sight for everyone to enjoy. Most of this scenery is created by natural erosion that goes on continually for centuries, exposing the hidden beauty underneath. Sometimes, however, this process is sped up when certain man-made events happen. One of these events is called a road cut. In many ways, road cuts are a geologist's best friend. They provide an opportunity to see what's below the Earth's surface and get a good look at the unaltered, hidden layers that wouldn't normally have been seen without these necessities of civilization. One intriguing road cut that was just made in 2023 is in the town of Toquerville, about 20 miles northeast of St. George, Utah. This road cut reveals some rather colorful sedimentary layers, including their curious angle or tilt. In our travels down the back roads of the Southwest, we've seen a lot of interesting road cuts, but nothing stacks up to the tilted angle and multiple colors of this road cut. This tilt shows us something we can't easily see elsewhere: what happened beneath the Earth's surface at a specific point in time. There was an interaction and dynamic going on here with a nearby significant geologic feature, the Hurricane Fault. Keep watching and you'll learn more about that. This road cut was made while building what's known as the Toquerville Bypass. It reroutes Highway 17, which starts in the neighboring town of Laverkin and ends just 6 miles north at its junction with Interstate 15. The goal of the bypass is to route the busy traffic away from the small, picturesque town of Toquerville and have it go to the west where there is wide open, undeveloped land. When this video was made, we used Google Maps to navigate to South Ash Creek Drive and Rimview Drive in Toquerville. Once we got there, we parked near these mailboxes and walked a few hundred feet beyond them to look down into the road cut. Whether or not you'll be able to view the road cut from this vantage point once the construction is finished is unknown at this time. During a more recent visit, it looked like the area around the cut is still being modified. This is what you see from the edge. The road cut slices through this ridge that is bordered by Ash Creek on one side and existing Highway 17 on the other. The most striking part of the road cut are these multicolored layers that dominate the cut's lower two-thirds. Each layer is a different color and is quite thin. The multicolored layers are part of what geologists call the Iron Springs Formation. More on that later. This cross-section reveals four episodes of erosional deposition. The first, on top, is the newest addition, consisting of alluvial deposits and areas sand that in recent times accumulated at the top. Next down is this layer of dense basalt, which was created from a lava flow originating about 10 miles north of here. See our video tour of Where to Find Scenery in Southwest Utah, Part 1, to learn more about this volcanic eruption. The next layer down are these alluvial deposits here. Like the top layer, this seems to consist of areas sands and dirt, along with large boulders that washed down from surrounding hillsides, which is the definition of alluvium. The bottom layer is the Iron Springs Formation, which is made up of all these multicolored sublayers. Notice how it's also angled differently than all the other layers above it. Pretty cool, isn't it? Here's a drone's view of the road cut. Over here is the Hurricane Fault, which we'll include in our discussion later. Here's the ridge the road cut was dug through, and this is existing Highway 17. We'll now dip down into the road cut. Over here is Ash Creek, whose rushing waters etched out this canyon through the hard basalt. Here's the bridge that's being constructed for the Toquerville bypass over Ash Creek. This is another drone flight that shows a different perspective of the road cut. Here's the Pine Valley Mountains, and here you can see the future path of the bypass taking shape. Now, we'll fly down into the road cut itself. As we get to the center of the future road, we can see those colorful layers on each side of the road cut. Unfortunately, since this was taken in the winter, the sun was low in the sky, and the south side of the cut is in the shade. The next use of the drone is to take a really close look at the layers on both sides of the cut. Yes, not only are road cuts a geologist friend, but so are drones. They make it so much easier to photograph things from different and impactful perspectives. Now we'll take in a complete 360-degree view, looking in both directions of the future road. As we get good views of the multicolored layers, you can really see the detail of each environmental episode that was going on during that period of time in Earth's history. We'll get an even closer look in a moment. You're now looking at the south side of the road cut that has a larger exposure of the colorful Iron Springs Formation. Of all the geologic formations we've closely examined, we've never seen anything like this, with all these thin, distinctive layers. And this is facing southeast towards Highway 17. Here is the Hurricane Fault and Hurricane Mesa. All right, one last drone flight. This shows the northern cut in the sunlight with all the crazy layers and colors. These marks here are scratches left behind by the drilling equipment that carved out the road cut. But the main purpose of this flight is to get a close-up view of the top layers, mainly the basalt. You can see here, below the basalt, that this was most likely riverbed deposits that included these larger boulders. Then, here is the basalt flow itself. And finally, on top, are those alluvial deposits, which was the last earthen material to be laid down. Okay, enough of looking around this site. Let's now talk about the geology going on here, so that you can really appreciate what's happening, or rather, what happened. The colorful layers in the road cut are from the Iron Springs Formation mentioned earlier. They were deposited in the late Cretaceous period, between 95 to 65 million years ago. To put some perspective to this timeline, you may recall that the dinosaurs went extinct around 65 million years ago. Listen to the description of the Iron Springs Formation as given by the Utah Geological Survey. The formation is variously colored grayish-orange, pale yellowish-orange, dark yellowish-orange, white, pale reddish-brown, and greenish-gray, and is locally stained by iron manganese oxides, which accounts for the reddish colors. Does that fit the description of what's being seen here? Yep. Each of these little layers with different colors is a record of what I referred to earlier as environmental episodes. They're like tree rings, where each ring indicates what type of environment the tree was living in for that year. Here, each of these colors indicate what type of earthen material flowed through during that period. And that period wasn't a year like a tree ring. No, it was probably thousands of years. A few similar places where you can see different types of deposited, colorful material are Artist Palette in Death Valley, California, or the Perea Town Site in Utah. So why are the layers of the Iron Springs Formation tilted in the direction we see? There's only one explanation for that, and it's the fault of the Hurricane Fault. Let me explain. Remember how I was pointing out the Hurricane Fault in the previous views? It's close by. Using Google Earth, we can see, here, the trace of the Hurricane Fault. If you've watched our previous video on touring this area, which is a two-part video, you'll know that the Hurricane Fault is the western border of the Colorado Plateau and is partially responsible for pushing up this large chunk of land about a mile high, which is pretty amazing in itself. You'll also learn why I'm saying hurricane and not hurricane. This uplift is the reason for the unique geology east of the fault, as well as the reason why the Grand Canyon is about 1 mile deep. Many depositional layers were uplifted. Then, in many places, such as Zion and Grand Canyon, water dug deep, up to a mile deep in some places, down into those underlying layers. On the west side of the fault, like in St. George and Toquerville, the same layers in the Colorado Plateau exist, but at a different elevation. Here, our Roadcut and the Iron Springs Formation sits at an elevation of 3,000 feet, or 900 meters. The same Iron Springs Formation is also famously exposed on the Kaparowitz Plateau in the Grand Staircase Escalante National Monument. See our Kaparowitz Plateau road trip video tour for more info about this area. The whole eastern edge of the Kaparowitz Plateau is called the Straight Cliffs and consists mostly of Iron Springs Formation. Locally on the Kaparowitz, this formation is known as the Straight Cliffs Formation. The top of the Iron Springs Formation here is at an elevation of 6 to 7,000 feet, or 2,000 meters. 7,000 feet minus 3,000 feet. That's quite an offset. The Hurricane Fault not only caused the uplift and raised these formations, but it also tilted to the east slightly, as the arrows indicate. When this tilting occurred, the land on the west side of the fault sort of sank and tilted in the opposite direction and tilt as the east side. The west side, which is the basin and range, was being stretched from here all the way across Nevada and into California. This aerial image was taken a few miles south of our road cut from the Confluence Park overlook at the end of Main Street in Hurricane. Notice these two ridges that are tilted. Notice these lines indicating the tilt. Incidentally, here is the location of our road cut. Now, notice the tilt of the colorful layers in the Iron Springs Formation at our road cut. They're roughly the same, at about 20 degrees. To illustrate further what's going on, here is a cross-section of the Hurricane Fault. Notice the fault is at a roughly 70-degree tilt. And to illustrate the tilting, these arrows point out the direction of both the sinking on the Basin and Range, or west side, and the tilted uplift on the Colorado Plateau side. Also, notice the location of the Kaibab Formation, which is the limestone layer exposed above the town of Laverkan. In the cross-section, it's way down here on the fault's west side. On the east side of the fault, it's located way up here, where it's exposed. Here in the cross-section is about where our road cut is located. In the cross-section, notice the location of the Iron Springs Formation. Just below it, notice this large section, which is the Navajo Sandstone Formation. It becomes exposed in the Babylon area, just 3 miles west of our road cut. So, thanks to the road cut, we can clearly see the tilt caused by the earth sinking on the west side of the fault. Otherwise, the tilt would only be noticeable and quite inconspicuous by looking at these nearby ridges. Alright, so there's one more interesting piece of geology that, thanks to this road cut, reveals this piece, even though it needs a brief explanation of what you're seeing. In the Grand Canyon, have you ever heard of the Great Unconformity? This is where it is obvious that several large layers of geology were removed by erosion. It's a mystery as to how big they were or what material they consisted of. In our road cut, remember the four layers I pointed out previously? Between the Iron Springs Formation and the next layer up, there was a significant layer that used to exist, but it was eroded and/or washed away. This missing layer, or layers, is in fact an unconformity. Not the great unconformity in the Grand Canyon, but a smaller one. This unconformity mainly consisted of what's called the Clairon Formation. And what's the Clairon Formation famous for? The unique geology of Bryce Canyon National Park, as well as similar geology at Cedar Breaks National Monument, the latter of which is just 35 miles northeast of our road cut. And why did the Clairon Formation erode so easily as compared to other layers, such as the Navajo Sandstone and Iron Springs Formation? When you look closely at the Clairon, you'll see that it's softer material, which makes it easier to be washed away. We know that the Clairon extended this far west to our road cut, because only 10 miles to the west, Clairon Formation is exposed at the base of the Pine Valley Mountains. In fact, that base is also Iron Springs Formation, but it's not too visible due to all the vegetation. As you can see in this stratigraphy chart I showed earlier, that shows the location of the Iron Springs Formation in relation to other formations, you can see that the Clairon is located just above it. So that is the last piece to our puzzle, all exposed to us now, thanks to this new road cut. Isn't it amazing to see how all the pieces of a very large jigsaw puzzle come together? It's why geology is so fascinating to us. Yes, this landscape is beautiful, but isn't it just a little more interesting when you know more about its complex nature? So, thanks to this new road cut, we can see some of those puzzle pieces a bit more clearly now. Although this wasn't our typical backroads adventure, we hope you enjoyed this interesting new site that is now available for everyone to enjoy. And now that you've watched this video, we hope that when you take road trips from now on, you'll pay a little more attention to the road cuts you drive through and wonder what geologic story they are telling you. You might also start to wonder what's just below the surface of the landscapes you're passing by. Thanks for watching our video, and until next time, we bid you happy exploring!